whatever they do has come to Jesus Christ. Jesus had an old-fashioned offer. How many believes that? The best thing you can do is give your heart to the Lord tonight. I mean, he knows that. His name is Jesus. Say it with me, Jesus. I want to tell you something. The Bible talks about Moses and how he forsook the treasures of Egypt for the children of Israel. He forsake everything that was in Egypt. And I want you to just think what Jesus did. He left all of heaven to come and dwell in, to die on an old rugged cross so he could have a relationship with you and I tonight at Solid Rock. So let's give him a great big hand. How many knows it's all about that? I tell you what, I love him tonight. He's a great big God. He's greatly to be praised. I tell you, look at your neighbor and say, ain't you glad for Calvary? I want to tell you, he chose, and I was thinking about that as they sing that, the best thing I ever did do, the best thing I ever did do was come to an altar and give my life to the Lord. He bathed my heart. He took that old stony heart, as Brother Ronnie says, and he gave me a heart that I could love with. And I tell you what, I can't thank him enough. He's a great big God. And I tell you, let's just go before him and welcome him. Let's just go before the Lord in prayer. Let's welcome him into our midst tonight. I tell you what, this nice service is all about Jesus. How many believes that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Father, we welcome the presence of you tonight.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Father, we come before that throne in the mighty name of
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Thank you for touching hearts and lives in this building tonight. Oh, Lord, that man of God. God healed tonight, saved tonight, and smiled. Lord, minister tonight with your mighty hand. Father, with your mighty power. Lord God, God, break out of this place tonight. God, break out in it tonight. Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost. Father, we love you. God, we honor you tonight. Thank you.
Jesus tonight, I tell you. I bless his name, I tell you. He's been good to me. The Bible says that men would give thanks unto the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. And I want to tell you, it's because of that mercy that we are here tonight. You can be seated just for a moment. Hallelujah. Let's give him a hand clap. Hallelujah. 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 If the hand sign wants to go ahead and be getting ready to perform, at this time, let's give Brother Ernie a hand as he comes up front and testifies. Hallelujah.
House of the Lord again tonight. Praise the Lord. Went to neurosurgeon Thursday in Lexington. They did an MRI and everything. He said looked good. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Glad of that. Praise God. Still have to take chemo though, but that's still all right because God is still on the throne. Praise the Lord. He's the one that's going to take care of it anyway. Praise the Lord. Just thank him tonight for being such a good God to me.
Hallelujah. 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 Brother Glenn Stevens, won't you come on up front and testify, brother? Come on up front. Hallelujah.
Give him the Lord a good hand.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother Jerry, why don't you come on up front and testify tonight? Hallelujah.
Well, good to be in the house of the Lord.
Yes,
amen. Amen. There's nowhere I'd rather be than to be in the presence of the Lord.
Of the Lord.
Amen. But David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. In the house of the Lord. A lot of people said unto, but he says in. Amen. And I'm always glad, Brother Wayne, to give honor and praise to the Lord, because without him, we'd be a failure. But with him tonight, we've got all that we need. Amen. Hallelujah. I love the Lord tonight, and I apologize for Sister Hatton. I left her home sick. Amen. So just pray for her. And amen. But God's going to move tonight, I believe. Amen. I believe Brother Manley's got a word for us, and I've come to expect it. Amen. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a praise. Will you do it?
Hallelujah. Give him a great big hand. Hallelujah. 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 How many's glad to be here tonight? Hey, man, I tell you what, I love the Lord tonight. At this time, if the offering takers would come on up to the front, Sister Rachel, will you come and sing tonight? How about you, Sister Sheila? Can you come and sing tonight? Hallelujah. Give her a great big hand as she comes up front to sing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother David Keith, come on up front and testify while we're waiting on him. Hallelujah. Give him a hand.
I just want to thank the Lord for another opportunity to be in the house of the Lord.
Yes.
And I want to thank him for his love, mercy, and grace. And he's kept us another week. And just pray and anoint the word tonight and everybody receives.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
About to praise the Lord tonight. I'm just so glad that he's got a building program going.
Give Jesus a great big hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I mean, he's going to a city where the builder and maker's God. Amen. I tell you what, I'm looking forward to laying eyes on Jesus one day. I tell you, I'm in no hurry to die, but when it comes my time to go and I behold his face for the first time, you know, I love Jesus. I tell you, he bathed my heart in love. I tell you, he forgave me of all my sins. And not only that, but his mercy endures forever. I tell you what, he's a great big God. Let's give him a hand clap. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. At this time, first thing I want to ask you, is everybody glad to be here tonight? Everybody glad to be here tonight? How many's excited to be here tonight? Tell you what, looking forward to a move of God. How many's looking forward to a move of God? I was thinking this brother Jerry's talking about David being glad to go into the house of the Lord. That was because there was something at the house of the Lord that excited David. You know that? And I'll tell you what, we've got that same power, that same Holy Ghost power moving in our midst tonight. How many believes that? Hallelujah. At this time, help me make welcome our pastor, Pastor Wayne Keith. Give him a hand clap.
Let's give the Lord a shout of praise tonight. How many glad to be in the house of the Lord, as Brother Michael done said. Amen. Amen. I want you to turn around and shake 4 or 5 hands before you're seated tonight. Amen. Go across the aisle, welcome somebody. Tell them, amen, good to see them in the house of the Lord tonight. Well, King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. When I'm down here in trouble, Lord, send the Holy Ghost by my way. Well, some said, give me silver. Some said, give me gold. Well, I said, give me Jesus. He's the only God I know. King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. When I'm down here in trouble, send the Holy Ghost on my way. Well, they put old Paul in prison long about the midnight hour. Paul sung a new song. God shook that jailhouse free. Yeah, he did. Hallelujah. Woo! Come on, somebody. Give the Lord a shout of praise if you believe that tonight. Amen. Come on, give God another praise in this. I feel revival in here tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen. God's a good God tonight. Well, they put old Paul in prison long about the midnight hour. Paul sung a new song. God shook that jailhouse free. Yeah, he did. I know you hear me when I pray. Well, I'm down here in trouble. Send the Holy Ghost by my way. Well, some said, give me silver. Some said, give me gold. I said, give me Jesus. He's the only God I want, King Jesus. I know you hear me. The Lord a shout of praise if you believe that tonight. Amen. Come on, give him a praise. Amen.
Well, King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. Well, King Jesus, I know you hear me when I pray. Because when I'm down here in trouble, just send the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Some say give me silver, some say give me gold. Oh, but I say give me my Jesus, he's the only God I know.
Jesus, he'll deliver you, King Jesus. Don't you hear me when I pray? When I'm down here in trouble, send the Holy Ghost by my way. King Jesus, I know you hear me. Praise if you believe that in the house tonight. Amen. Amen. Remain standing if you would tonight. Amen. By the grace of God. Amen. And I want to say this tonight before we turn it to the man of God tonight. I want to thank those that have been battling in their bodies great infirmities. And they come onto the house of God and faithful. Amen. And, you know, they run risks just like him, anything. But they're in the house of God. Sister Jean's sitting up there. Brother Ernie's sitting here. That brother over here. That sister over here. But God's so good. And I want you to just give them and the Lord just a great, great big hand. Amen. 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 At this time, it's my honor and my privilege to introduce to you, amen, one of the finest preachers I know. Amen. I appreciate Brother Manley. Amen. I appreciate his ministry. I appreciate what God's doing with him. Amen. And I want you tonight to be encouraged in the Word of God. Now, would you make Brother Walter Manley from Gaston, Tennessee, welcome tonight? Come on, make him welcome tonight. Hallelujah. Give him a solid rock praise.
Bless you, brother. I love you, man.
Bless you, man.
Take care.
Praise the Lord. You can be seated. God bless you. Look at you. Just looking good. Hallelujah. Don't be boasted too much, though. He said he'd beautify you with holiness. It's the only reason we're looking good. One writer said, if it had not been for the Lord, where would we be? My God. He cleans us up real good. Hallelujah. He takes the rough edges off and smooths them out and sharpens us in the Holy Ghost. He heals our body when we get saved. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. My God, I believe he healed my mind. Mark Hamby wrote the song, look what the Lord has done. He's healed my body. He's touched my mind. He saved me just in the lick of time. And we just thank the Lord for the opportunity to be here. I'm apologizing for my wife. She could not make it. We got ministers at our house as we're here. The Nails, good friends of ours, they decided to stay with us about 3 to 4 weeks. Amen. At our cabin. So Teresa's entertaining there. And I just thank the Lord for Brother Jerry that's sitting by me. At least I'm not sitting by myself. Appreciate he came, and his wife stayed home, a little sick, but we're believing it's not the flu. Amen. I told him, if it's the flu, find a separate bedroom, because he has to preach Wednesday and Sunday. I said, brother, don't get the flu. Don't get the flu. Good to have my friend and longtime acquaintance, Brother Glenn Stevens. I guess Glenn Stevens was the first preacher, when I became pastor, to visit my church and hold me a revival. Brother Glenn was the first evangelist at that time to come and hold us a revival, and that's been 35 years ago, and you may not remember that, but you came up, you and a guitar player, I don't know his name, but I just thank the Lord that you came for a three-night revival. That was a long time ago. Praise the Lord, and we go way back. So appreciate you being here tonight. Appreciate all the rest of you, all the acquaintance I know from camp meeting coming down, and all the friends and the family, and God is good. I prayed and sought the Lord on the 4.5 hours coming down here, and I said, Lord, what would you have me to preach? You know, you get a few sermons in life after pastoring and preaching 3,000 or 4,000 messages in your life, but I really believe God's got something for us tonight. I just pray you're ready. I'm going to preach like the house is full, and it's almost full, and I'm going to preach with a passion and a hardness and a strive, and I believe we're going to see a move of God. Amen. Last week, we seen 7 saved in Mississippi. God moved, and people's lives were touched, so I don't believe he's any different in Mississippi as in Kentucky. So all I can tell you, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. If you're sick, get ready, get ready. If you need the Holy Ghost, get ready. If you need to be saved, get ready. If you need a marriage healed, get ready. For the Lord is in the house, and he's here to touch. I believe he's here to touch. Glory to God. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. My God, it's good. Good to know your pastor and his wife and his family. What an honor to know them throughout the years. And I just praise the Lord for more than just our acquaintances, but our friendship. Amen. Means so much. The Bible says, how can you do it by yourself? Threefold cord. I thank God for the ministers I have that I draw strength from, and your pastor's one of them that I call often to get wisdom and advice. So I thank the Lord and give him and Sister Keith a big hand. There you are. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is good. Appreciate you, Pastor, so much for allowing us to be here. Praise the Lord. In the book of Luke, I apologize up there, but I'll give you time to get to it. In the book of Luke 10:38 through 42. In the book of Luke, chapter 10:38 through 42. Praise the Lord. I should have got it to them earlier, but look how fast they are. They're good. Praise the Lord. I thank the Lord for you that are able to stand, kids included. Amen. God is good. One day, my mama used to not be able to stand at 90-some years old, and she said, I can't go to church no more. I said, why? Because they're always wanting me to stand, and I'm in my wheelchair. I said, Mama, you done stood enough. We're not talking to you. So you that stood enough, we're not talking to you. You've paid your dues. But I'm just talking about us young at heart. Praise the Lord. It came to pass as they went, they entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbered about much serving and came to him and said, Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her therefore that she come and she help me, please. And Jesus answered and said, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things, but one thing is needful. And Mary has chosen that good part. Listen, Mary has chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. Brother Jerry, would you pray over this, please? Before you're seated. Before you're seated. Amen. I noticed the other day ago, Kentucky played, I believe, Tennessee. I'm not sure. But all I know, there was a bunch of racket on both sides. And probably the right team didn't win or the wrong team won. And then I watched them the other day go play Alabama, and I think they made a bunch of racket there. You know, it's amazing how much noise they make over that basketball. And nothing's wrong with that. Nothing's wrong with that. And I always text. I don't hardly ever text, but I text Sister Hatton once the team's beaten Kentucky, and I always root for the other team. She'll get so mad. I can see her there just trying to text back on that little flip phone she's got. But we have a lot of fun over that. But it's a shame that we make more noise over a ball game than over the Savior. For the next 10 seconds, let's give Jesus the best praise. Let's give him our best praise. Come on, let's give him our best praise. He is worthy to be praised. In Jesus' name. You may be seated. Thank you so much. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to minister one more scripture up there. You're doing good up there. In Proverbs 11 and 1, I can quote it, but they'll throw it up there in a minute. I want to minister on a false balance. A false balance. The Bible says a false balance, Proverbs 11 and 1, a false balance is an abomination to the Lord, but a just weight is his delight. I thank God for balance in the church. I thank God for balance in our lives. But sometimes we can get so occupied and so stirred with passion from one side to the other that we have an out-of-balance life. You know some people that are like that. And I could go into many areas in that. But I'm only going to go in one area tonight. Hey, man, this could be a series. I want to go on the balance of being a Martha or being a Mary. And I thank God for Martha's. And Martha's gets a bad rap. We always put Martha down. And I got me, Abigail, my Martha tonight. She's a pretty girl. So, hey, man, where's she at? Where's she at? There you are. Come on up here. Just don't be shy. I told you what to do. Get all prettied up there. And, you know, Martha gets a bad rap. You know, many times we read that scripture and think, my God, Martha. She ain't no count, but I disagree. Martha's pretty good on a good Saturday morning with eggs a-frying and scratch biscuits and country ham. And my God, that ain't bad, I'm telling you. It's good to have Martha's to cook pies for those that are sick in the hospital. It's good to have Martha's to send cards to the sick. So don't be too critical over Martha. See, Martha, what she was doing, she was cooking victuals for Jesus and those 12 hungry, lousy disciples that just came in and took over. I mean, when you get 13 people coming to your house and then some visitors, you're going to have somebody to cook some victuals. And I could just see, my friend, I know Abigail, Brother Little, you've taught her to cook. I know she knows probably how to cook different things in life, but I thank God for little Martha here. She's cooking up a storm and she's serving the people. She's pouring the tea. And when the glass gets empty, she'll run down to big boisterous Peter and pour him some more. And then Thomas is doubting he'll ever get any more. And then she runs down there. And my God, all of a sudden, somebody eats a big leg of chicken and Martha's being ran ragged. But don't be too hard on her, because we got to have Marthas. We got to have Marthas in the church to greet people. The Bible says that we have the gift of helps. And I thank God for Marthas. I got good Marthas at Liberty Hall Church when I pastored 34 years. My God, we could have a dinner back there off the gym in that fellowship. My God, we could cook catfish, Brother Jerry. We could have the shrimp bowl. I had women that were workers. I call them Marthas. We could have homecoming, and there would be food ready. Man, them Marthas. We got to have Marthas. Marthas, Marthas. And, you know, I thank God for Marthas. I thank God that I have took the role of a Martha. Oh, you can be a man and still take the role of a Martha. I'm more than just a pastor when I pastored 34 years, but I am a father to 3 children. I am a grandfather to 9 grandchildren. I have a four-wheeler. I have 2 kayak little boats. I got catfish I got to feed. I've got to take the kids on the four-wheeler. I've got to make sure that I take turns. Teresa wants to have them all over at one time. I tell them that's not wise. Take turns. So we got to take turns. And it seems like, my God, I'm a spiritual Martha to these grandkids. I've got to take care of them. I've got to make sure my kids, when do they ever get grown? When their car breaks down and they don't call you, Brother Wayne? I know yours don't, but you know, when does that ever stop? My God, my kids are full grown, and I'm still being a father to them, a Martha. I'm taking care of them. I'm footing the bills sometimes, Brother Jerry. I'm taking care of the catfish. I'm taking care of my vehicles. I'm taking care of my motorhome. I'm taking care of the maintenance and care on my house. It seems like all I get done, the more I get. I'm just a Martha being pulled this direction and that. And then I had my mom and dad have a trailer right next to us. My God, you talk about getting busy then. My God, we moved them down from Indiana, and now I'm a pastor, I'm a dad to three kids, I'm a grandpa to nine grandkids, and I'm being a son to a mom and dad that's elderly. And all of a sudden, I find myself being pulled in this direction. Keep stirring, dear. Keep pulling in this direction. My God, I feel like I'm being pulled apart. I've got to take care of this. I remember once Mama called on the phone. I ain't going to tell you what she calls me, but Jerry knows. She don't call me Pastor Manley. And she yelled out, "I fell and I can't get up. I fell." And she's in the trailer. My dad's done passed. And I told my wife, I said, "Get the key. We got to go rescue Mama." She couldn't find the key. Mama, it ain't funny. She's 93 years old, laying in the floor, crying, screaming on the phone, in panic. Me and Teresa's looking for the key. I'm fussing at her. She's fussing at me. And because we're trying to be good son to my mama, our marriage is getting in a mess. And before I know it, I'm accusing my wife, and she's accusing me. And I'll never forget when finally I said, "Mama, put the blanket on, we're going to break the window." You could hear her scream for three blocks away. Oh my God, I broke that window, rescued Mama. Immediately she wrote a letter to my sister in New Albany and told everything about it in the wrong way. Before I knew it, I got a letter back from my sister that I'm abusing my mama. I'm thinking, my God, I'm tired of being a Martha. I'm trying to help people. I'm trying to do this. I'm trying to do that. I'm so busy being a Martha. I ain't a Mary no more. And then my mind, you don't look like that. Can I use you? She's going to be our Mary. And this is a little box, and in her box is her costly living. She has the long hair and her tears. And she's not boisterous. She's not big, but just fall down at your feet here and just worship the Lord. You know, I'll never forget when I just got saved, Brother Jerry. I used to follow Dwayne Caldwell a lot because me and him was best friends. He was the best man in my wedding, and he had a big part of me being saved. And I'll never forget. Back then, I wasn't a preacher. Back then, I wasn't even married. All I had was Jesus on my mind. And I used to go to his singings, and he used to sing "The Lighthouse." And I used to be a Mary, and I would weep uncontrollably from the first of the song to the end. He would sing, "I know a man who can." And my God, I'd get up and I'd come to an altar and I'd weep uncontrollably till I couldn't weep no more. But then I evaluate my life after serving God 40 years. I've been so occupied, Brother Wayne, being a Martha to my family and a Martha to my church and a Martha to take care of the growth in my church. And I'm so occupied in taking care of Liberty Hall for 34 years. I got to make sure the air is right. I got to make sure the sound is right. I got to make sure everybody's greeted. I got to make sure I don't miss somebody in the congregation, because my God, I wouldn't want to miss nobody. And I got to make sure the sound isn't too loud. And I got to make sure they keep the right appropriate songs. And even if I have a guest speaker, I got to make sure the mood is right for the preacher to be turned loose. And then I want to be a Mary at the altar call, but then I'm called away from that because I'm trying to help the preacher pray for people. And before you know it, Brother Jerry, I have found myself being a Martha unto a congregation for
34 years. I've took care of everything from commodes running over, worried about this and worried about the crowd and worried about this and doing that. I'm a Martha and we need Marthas. But I finally got to a place in life. I gotta be a Mary. I've got to just worship him. And I've tried it in services, and then somebody had tapped me on the shoulder, come pray for somebody. But I don't want to pray for somebody. I just want to worship, and I want to wipe his feet with my tears. And I just want to take my spiritual hair and wash his feet. But, oh, I've got to do my duty. I've got to take care of this. And before you know it, I'm pulled between the two. And I found myself. Nothing's wrong with Martha's. But I've got so occupied being a Martha, I almost... pastoring 34 years, forgot how to be a Mary. I forgot how to be a Mary. How do I worship again? Where are the tears, Pastor? Where are the passion I used to cry out? Where is when I used to fall in love and sing the songs over and over again? Where is that? I've lost something. It's so easy to get out of balance. Hadnobashatai. It's so easy to get out of balance. But, oh, I've come to the place in life. I may pass you by and not shake your hand. And I may forget to turn the heat up or turn it down. And I may forget to do such and such. But if there's anything I want to do is fall at the feet of Jesus every service and be a spiritual Mary unto a Christ that saved me. I mean, he didn't have to die for me. He didn't have to shed his blood for me. He rescued me from a drunk tank in Brownstown, Indiana at the age of 20. Long hair, holes in my blue jeans. He saved me. He cleansed me. He gave me a brand new mind. He gave me a brand new life. I've got to stop sometimes. And nothing's wrong with Martha's. We need them. Don't be bad on this girl. Nothing's wrong. We got to have them. We don't have enough of them. But if you are, have you ever seen some people in church? I watch people. Bible says watch and pray. I watch people. Sometimes people's always concerned about everybody else. I watch some of these spiritual ladies in church. They're always concerned about this one. They're always concerned. Pray for this one, Pastor. Always concerned about. Pray for this one, Pastor. Always concerned about. This is my boy. Pray for him. And then I watch them week after week, and they're always concerned. They're going to make a pie for such and such. They're going to do this. They're going to bless the pastor with a big basket of tomatoes, and that's good, and that's all good. But there's sometimes we can get so occupied in taking care of others that we need to just sometimes stop. And I got to be a Mary today. I ain't worried about my kids, where they're sitting or if they're too noisy. I'm not worried about praying for others right now. I've got to worship him. I've got to be a Mary. When's the last time you took on the role of a Mary? She brought all she had. Paul said, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body as a living sacrifice. When's the last time you finally just said, I give up and let Jesus take over? I want to be a Martha, but I want to be a Mary. I want to be both into a dying world. I feel the Holy Ghost in you. Somebody's going to find their role being turned in the right direction. You're so occupied about your mother-in-law. I'm preaching to somebody. If it wasn't for my wife, I'd been in a mess taking care of my mama. If it wasn't for my wife, Jerry, you know the situation. My God, I'd never been able to do it and pastor a church that was growing. But thank God for Teresa Manley. But Teresa Manley knew what it was to change diapers on a 90-year-old woman. Knew what it was to give a dad of mine shots in the belly. I mean, thank God for Teresa. She takes care of me when I'm sick. Thank God for Teresa. She's a grandma. But I love it when Teresa leaves the role of all that. And nobody can worship God like my wife. When she starts sucking that air, Brother Jerry, and waving them hands, and she starts going and worshiping God, that's the woman I married. That's the woman I loved. And many times I find that I've kept her so busy in life, taking care of this and taking care of that. And all that's needful. She has to be the pastor's wife to a church and all the women and all that's needed, but the stress of it all and the hurt of it all and the people hurting her sometimes she don't even want to become a Mary no more. She just wants to stay home. We've all found ourselves weary, as they play me something soft, well doing. But I want to thank God for our Marthas. We need you, so don't quit. We need you to help others in our community. We need you to greet people. The fields are white, but the Marthas are few. We need these Marthas in our church to be able to hug somebody and encourage somebody and shake hands with somebody. We need the Marthas to financially support our church and keep it going. And all that's good. Don't quit. But it's so neat, Brother Wayne, that you can be a Martha and be a Mary also. I finally learned how to do it. Sometimes you just got to say, I love y'all, but not now. Not now. They know not to mess with Daddy praying down at the cabin or at the church. Dad, I need some money for Gap. I'm being a Mary. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. But you got to be a father to your children. There's a time for all things, but you can let the devil slip into all this, trying to be good to everybody and trying to be the good husband and trying to make every ball game and trying to do everything just perfect and trying to be this and trying to. And if you're not careful, we'll get so busy in being a Martha and helping everybody and being the best in our community, man of the year in our community, woman of the year, that when's the last time your pastor seen you fall at this altar? Could not you pray with me 1 hour? What's in your box? It's all I have. When's the last time you gave him all you had? I'm guilty. I'm even guilty tonight because I've got to be mindful of this altar service. I want to see people filled with the Holy Ghost. I want to see people saved. I want to see people healed. But I still want to put on the garment of prayer. A while ago, I just fell on my knees because I said, I'm not going to preach one thing and be something else. I've got to be a Mary. God, when's the last time you was a spiritual? When's the last time your wife, sir, seen you with tears in your eyes, weeping unto Jesus? When's the last time, sis, your kids seen you weeping at the altar? They know you're a good lady. You can cook and you can do this and you can do that. Let's take on the role of a Martha and a Mary in one body. Stand to your feet. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. A little different tonight. I ain't even looked at these notes. Korea basha ta 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 ta, shana da 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 ko. But Brother Wayne, we got to go to the hospital. I know we're doing that's right. But Brother Wayne, we've got to do that. I know we're doing that's right. But there's a time just to put the brakes on everything and say, I'm going to put on the role of a Mary. And you know what's so hard for me? I get calloused, Brother Little. I'm not saying I've seen it all, but I've seen a little. I get so callous because when they used to weep and cry at the altar, I'd weep with them. But I've seen it so much that it's hard sometimes for me to be this Mary. I'm just so tied up in pastoring so many years. I'm a Martha, and I've took the role of a Martha. Lord, teach me once again to be a Mary. that I'm not worried about if the sound's too loud or if it's not. I go into other churches and worry about it. You do too. I went into Pastor Joey's church and Teresa looked at me. I know it's too loud. She said, would you just leave it alone? I said, I'm learning. I'm even doing it at a church I'm not even pastoring. Brother Nail preached the other night ago, and I looked at Joey. It's time to close her up, meaning get up on the piano. I thought, Pastor, leave it alone. Leave it alone. Quit trying to do so much. Just stop. And then I stopped, and God spoke to me, and I came to the altar, the first one up there, and stayed and worshiped him. And I wasn't worried about what else was going on. Can we get to that place in life? Can we get to that place in life? Sir, young man, when's the last time you was a Mary? The scripture is right, Brother Wayne. Search me, O Lord. Try my reins. Search me, O God. Create in me the pureness in God. Please help me, God. It's so hard for kids, pastors' kids, to be and Mary, because my daughter said that, Dad, I love your preaching. You're one of my best preachers on the face of this earth. But you know, there's a relief after you left the church. Everybody ain't looking at me all the time. They's always looking at me before, and now I can just be myself. And I can put on the role of a Mary and not worried about being the PK kid. I said, I've never looked at it like that, Lindsay. She said, you just don't know the pressure it put on me. Everybody's staring at me, wondering if I'm going to make a mistake. Now I'm not the PK kid anymore. And I said, what a sacrifice you have done to be my daughter. And I thank you for it. Because sometimes I've made my kids a Martha and didn't even mean to. Tommy, go back here and do this. You know, just let them be their self in church. Let them be their self in church and take their personality of being a Mary. I feel the Holy Ghost, all eyes closed. All eyes closed, every head bowed. The Bible talks about being lukewarm. The Bible talks about being renewed. It's so easy to once have the goods and once have the power. And I'll say once have the passion. And then to lose it. It's called the first love. If you don't have your first love to be a Mary in his house, you may be on your way to a backslidden condition. If you've never found that, if you've never cried at an altar, if you've never said, Lord, I'm so thankful, you may not even be saved. Who's to judge only but the judge himself, Jesus? But ladies and gentlemen, I stand before you with every head bowed and every eye closed. If there's anybody under the sound of my voice, if you knew the Lord was coming in the next 30 seconds, would anybody say, member or not, Holy Ghost filled or not, I'm not saying that, would anybody say, Pastor, I'm just not really right where I need to be with God? Think about it. I'm just really not right. There's something lacking. If you're like that, I don't condemn you because I've been there being a pastor. It's time to renew and refresh like the piece of leather that gets crumpled and hard. If you're under the sound of my voice and you need to renew something, refresh something in your life, or you need to come to Jesus the first time, or you need to get saved all over again, nobody looking around, just put your hand up and put it right back down real quickly. Real quickly. Oh, I know I'm in a spiritual church, but I don't believe 100% in this church is perfect. There's one hand. Thank you, sir. What a man it takes to raise that hand. There's another. What a man. Yes, what a lady it takes to raise that hand. Anybody else? Anybody else under the sound of my voice? In a drunk tank, I got saved with no music, no church, no preacher. Anybody else under the sound of my voice? Going once? You can just put it up and put it right back down. I promise I won't even put you in the tank. We ain't got no water in there. And nothing like that's going to happen tonight. It's just acknowledging you need help. Going twice. Can you say, yes, I need help also? Put your hand. There's a hand. Yes. Now everyone look at me. It's so neat to know that God don't have wimps in the kingdom. We're not going to let our buddies send us to hell. We're not going to let our girlfriends send us to hell. We're going to stand before God for ourselves. And you that raised your hands, what I want you to do, I want Pastor and his wife to stand down here. And they love you. And I'm not saying you're backslid, and they know you're probably not. You just may need a boost. You may need help, or you may need saved. And as Pastor and his wife stands down here, you four or three that raised your hands, I know the devil don't want you to come because people think something. But, hey, come on down here, Sister Keith. But it don't matter. Hey, at the count of three, one, devil, I bind and rebuke you. Two, in the name of Jesus. Three, why don't you come on down? Give them a hand as they come, them four that lifted up their hand. What if they don't come? What if they do? Come on down here. There's one. There's another. There's another. One more over here, sir. Would you please come? We won't do nothing but pray for you. Oh, yes, they're coming. They're coming. Come on, give them a bit. The Bible says all heaven and angels rejoice. Come on up here like you're huddling up in a football team. Real close, real close, real close, real close. And Pastor, you just pray for them, and I'm going to pray for some others, please. Oh, come on, let's worship him. Go ahead, brother, you got it. We're going to pray for some people. There's some people needs healing in your body. I believe God's going to heal you and touch you by that. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I said, I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Shana da 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 koya basatai. Shana da 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 koya basatai. In the name of Jesus. If you need prayer for your body and you're sick, meet me right here. God will heal your body. God will touch you tonight. In the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. We got anybody else right behind this man? We're going to pray for your body. Go ahead, brother. I'm doing this for me. I had a little cold. In the name of Jesus, I bind and rebuke all pain in this side. In the name of Jesus, I command it to loose his body. In the name of Jesus, I stand upon your word. I declare your word is true. Hanna basida di di oko. Hanna da 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 koya basatai. Be healed. He ta 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 ta. We'll be right back.
Come on, let's all just come down to this front tonight and say, God, I still got a need. Amen. I still have a need tonight. I don't care how spiritual you may be tonight. Say, God, I still need to be a Mary. God, I thank you. God, I've done the Martha thing. But God, I want to be a Mary tonight. I want to bless the name of the Lord. Would you come? Would you come and say, God, just want to be a Mary tonight. God, I just want to be stirred in you tonight, God. Stirred by the power of God tonight. Stirred by the anointing of God tonight. Come on, just love me, honey.